By the end of his life, Edison held patents for over 1,300 different things. Besides the light bulb, phonograph, and motion picture camera, Edison held patents for things that we use every day. For example, the curling iron, the electric waffle maker, and the X-ray machine, as well as paraffin paper, which is still used today in many candy wrappers. Edison patented a design for a poured concrete house and concrete furniture, which never really caught on. Though Edison's Portland Cement Company built Yankee Stadium and aided in the construction of the Panama Canal. On March 20th, 1885, Edison purchased a 13-acre tract of land on the Caloosahatchee River in Fort Myers, Florida. And this is the tour of his winter estate. The winter estate, known as Seminole Lodge, consisted of the main house and a guest house. In 1886, Edison and his new bride, Minna Miller, enjoyed leisurely stays here until 1947, when Minna deeded Seminole Lodge to the city of Fort Myers for $1. All of the original furnishings are on permanent loan from the Edison family. The bamboo growing in Fort Myers enticed Edison to purchase the property. Bamboo fiber was one material Edison researched as a filament for the light bulb. The Edison guest house sitting room provided a casual, comfortable setting for visitors to Seminole Lodge. The room included fashionable Bar Harbor-style wicker furniture. The Lily Pond landscape feature was created in 1929. Today, it includes some of Minna's favorite plants, such as iris, water lilies, and papyrus. Minna Edison's Moonlight Garden was created in 1928. Ellen Biddle Shipman, a renowned landscape architect, designed the space. The pool and bright flowers were meant to reflect the moonlight. The pier was the first structure to be built after Edison acquired the property. It was originally much longer, reaching out approximately 1,500 feet to deeper water. It was used to bring building materials to the property from barges anchored in the river. Later outfitted with boathouses, benches, and a summer house, it became a favorite spot for fishing and visiting. In 1910, Edison ordered the construction of a pool at his estate. Constructed of three parts shell cinders and broken stone, two parts sand, and one part Portland cement, reinforced with galvanized iron bars. While Edison was not fond of swimming, his family enjoyed the pool. In 1929, Minna Edison hired contractors to improve the pool area, adding tiles, a dressing area, and a canopy. She called the finished product the tea house. A double row of mango trees was planted along the McGregor Boulevard fence line spanning the Edison property, and this became known as Orchid Lane. The banyan tree was a gift from Harvey Firestone. He brought it to Edison and it was planted in 1925. It was only 4 feet tall and 2 inches in diameter. The banyan is native to India. Edison's banyan is the largest of its species in the state of Florida.
with a circumference of 400 feet. The banyan tree was designated state championship tree in 1980. A museum and laboratory on the ground showcases the great man's many inventions.
I've been away from you a long time. I never thought I'd miss you so. Somehow I feel your love is real. Near you I want to be. The birds are singing, it is song time. The banjo's strumming soft and low. I know that you yearn for me too. Swanee, you're calling me. Swanee, how I love you, how I love you, my dear old Swanee. I'd give the world.
The 15,000 square foot museum houses many of Edison's famous inventions, plus photographs and much more, with changing special exhibits.
During World War I, Edison, Ford, and Firestone became aware that the supply of rubber in the U.S. could be cut off and there would be a major problem in their industries. In 1927, they set up the Edison Botanic Research Corporation. The lab was built in 1928 so that Edison could find a source of natural rubber from a plant that could grow in the U.S. Opened January 1929, the funding for the project came from Edison, Ford, and Firestone. The capital to start was $75,000, $25,000 from each of the three men.
More than 250,000 visitors visit the Edison Winter Home every year, making it the ninth most visited national historic home in the country.